So like I said, I'm torn because I admit I have to stop and go, you know, how much, if at the end of the day, people understand the spiritual core of transhumanism and the satanic nature of transhumanism, and they understand the connection to things like the pharmakia angle, and, you know, and that includes things, not just the drug side, but the technology side, which are sort of just two ways of achieving the same thing, an altered state of consciousness. You know, how much, you know, how crucial is it that they understand that they're not on a globe and that space is the spirit realm and it's all just feeding into the same thing? You know, in some ways, it does make me kind of loosen my grip, I think, a little bit on the pitchfork or whatever. You know, my zeal for, in some ways, I feel my zeal for the flat earth topic waning in certain ways, or just trying to stop and reevaluate, I guess, and put it all into the proper perspective, because, like we all know, we've got countless people out there who are, you know, they're all in with the flat earth and NASA fakery and all that, but then they still think that there's truth to be found in the esoteric. They still have warped ideas of God and warped ideas of the Bible, and they're still rejecting the gospel. They're still buying into all kinds of occult doctrines. So we can't sugarcoat that and act like the flat earth is this panacea for biblical truth. At the same time, though, there's tons of people who simply, by way of encountering the flat earth, coming, even having like zero background in any of the conspiracy topics, or maybe they're very new to it. That's what's amazing to me, is how many people that are very new to learning about the New World Order and any of it, like in the first year, 6 months, even just a few months in, and they encounter flat earth and they get it like very quickly, whereas people who've been doing lectures and writing books, and, you know, you got Doug Hamp out there, he, you know, knows all about Genesis 6 and the Illuminati and all this, but flat earth is just the silliest thing in the world to him. And you go, you know, I still can't quite wrap my head. Even if you're skeptical and you're just thinking that it's, even if you're not convinced, I still don't understand just that sort of that reaction of just being totally like just thinking it's the most absurd thing, and you just, all you want to do is, you know, it's like how many of these guys have just spent so much time and energy trying to refute something, and the bottom line is that they're always, you know, attacking all the straw men's, and they still, after how many years, are not really focusing in on the things that are continuing to fuel the whole flat earth movement, and that is the, you know, the things that can be tested and proven empirically, namely to do with curvature and rotation. You know, you just spend all this time getting sucked into talking about the Southern Pole stars and, you know, talking about how NASA, you know, not everyone at NASA could be lying, and we have, you know, Christian astronauts and yada, yada, yada. We've heard every single, you know, I don't think I've heard a new objection in over 2 years now to the flat earth, or the in defense of the heliocentric model. I really have not heard anything new, but yet we're still having these silly debates, and you go, you know, what happened? Can it not still be acknowledged that at the end of the day, there is, because I'm, you know, I'm interacting with so many of you, like through the channel and through other things, and I know, you know, from my personal experience and my personal connections with so many people, that there is tons of people who are within the flat earth, the biblical cosmology camp, who fully understand how it all connects to the broader agenda, and not a single iota of eschatological, you know, awareness is lost, whether it comes to transhumanism, whether it comes to, you know, the one world economic system, the technocracy, you name it. I mean, they fully get all of these things. So in some ways I kind of feel like at least it has to be flipped back, in the sense of, are you willing to agree to disagree, and then we can at least move forward on all the things we do agree with, because it's just getting so, it's getting pretty intense. And I don't know, maybe I'm just thinking about this a lot more lately because of all the seeing things like how the conference and this quote-unquote movement, where people are just putting all their eggs in the flat earth basket, regardless